What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. I'm Fresh Tofu, and today I am finally getting into some GFriend. More specifically, I'm going to be checking out their Sunrise dance practice. So a number of you guys have been asking for my Sunrise MV reaction for a while now, and I actually did plan to react to it. I actually had it bookmarked and everything, but when I was watching YouTube on my Xbox, I left the autoplay feature on. So like after the video that I was watching finished, it rolled straight into the MV, and I couldn't really stop it. Well, actually, that's not true. I could totally stop it, but I couldn't actually, like, pause it and, like, exit. I got sucked in, all right? As soon as it started playing, like, the first few seconds of the MV, it drew me in, and I ended up watching the entire thing, and it was great. But, yeah, so sorry about that. So sorry about that. But you know what? The dance practice is something I've been looking forward to as well. The little bits of the choreo they showed in the MV was just mind-blowing to me, so I was like, I need to check out the dance practice. So, yeah, that's what we're about to do. So I'm only familiar with two of the members of the group, Cindy, because of that crazy collaboration with Red Velvet Soli, G-Idle Soyeon, and Chungha, and Sohwan, who I actually got to meet. Last summer, when I was visiting my friend in Seoul, we were going out for lunch, and we went to a quiet little restaurant. There was a lot of older people there as well. I think, like, she and I were the only ones under 30. And, yeah, in the corner, she, like, my friend, who's a huge fan of GFriend, she, like, noticed Sohwan there. She's like, oh my god, that's GFriend Sohwan, that's an idol. And I was like, wait, really? Are you sure? And she's like, yeah, 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 totally. And as I looked closer, I was like, oh yeah, I think it's her. Oh my god, I think it's her. What do we do? And she was like, yeah, let's let her do her thing. You know, she just wants to probably just eat her lunch in peace. And I was like, okay, cool. And it was so crazy because, like, normally when idols go out, according to my friend, like, they wear, like, a mask because, you know, they don't want to get spotted. But considering the place was, like filled with a bunch of older people, I figured she probably was like, oh, you know, no one's going to recognize me here. Little did she know. But we, for the most part, we let her eat her meal, and we ate our own meal, and it wasn't until the very end where the fandom took over, and my friend was like, I just need to just be like, hey, I love your work. I'm just going to go over there and just say that I love her work. And I was like, okay, yeah, cool. I mean, I'm sure that's not going to be too bad, right? So, you know, she got up as we were leaving, and she's like, she introduced herself just briefly. She's like, oh, hi, you know, I love your work. You know, I'm a huge fan, and Sohwan was so cool with it. You know, she stood up and she started talking to my friend for like a good, you know, 2 to 3 minutes. It was all in Korean, so I didn't really understand what they were saying until she, you know, explained afterwards. But she was like, oh yeah, you know, I love my fans, and, you know, basically like really friendly things. And then, you know, she talked to me for a little bit in English. You know, her English isn't great, but it was still very cool for her to try, because I know in Korean culture it's very it's difficult for them to speak English, not because they don't know it, because they feel embarrassed to speak English because they don't want to look good, right? Or look bad. But yeah, she spoke in English, and in English, I told her, you know, I love your work, you know, you're a really good dancer. And she was like, yeah, thank you so much. And, you know, she shook my hand, and it was really cool, because, you know, just to see an idol just be like so chill and so like not full of themselves. I expect most idols are like that anyway, but it was just the first time I'd ever met an idol like face to face. Another thing I got out of that is she is, like, way shorter than what I thought she'd be, like. Because when I see her standing next to other idols, I mean, she seems like she towers over them. Like, she is way taller than Mamamoo, and I think Mamamoo is, like, one of the taller girl groups out there. But when she's standing next to me, I still had, like, an inch or two over her, and I'm not a very tall guy. So that was kind of neat to see. I was like, wow, like, these idols are, like, a lot shorter than I thought they were. But, yeah, so that's my story of how I met Sohwan, and, yeah, she's the only idol I've ever met in person. But, yeah, she seems super cool, super laid back, and, I won't mention, like, what the restaurant was, because I figured she probably goes there for a reason. Like, I figure, you know, like, she went there without her mask on, so that might be, like, her go-to spot to avoid, you know, fans or whatever. So, not gonna bring it up, not gonna mention where it's at, just in case she's still going there, and that's, like, her own little happy place. Yeah, Sohwan, super cool. Cindy seems really talented, and I'm sure the other members are just as cool. I feel like I really should look into them more. You know, like with most groups that I follow, you know, besides their music and their stages, I do try to learn more about them, check out their V-Lives and whatnot. But for whatever reason, I never did that for GFriend. I feel like I should. So yeah, I'll probably do that later on. But anyways, without further ado, let's go check out this freaking dance practice, because I'm ready to get blown away. Oh my god. Okay, yeah, that is so beautiful right there. If it wasn't for this opening move right here, I could have easily avoided the MV, but as soon as I saw them do that, I was like, I need to see what's going on. I need to sit for this. Oh man, what a way to start an MV. These girls are so freaking good when it comes to, like, just their handwork, their upper body stuff. So, like, a lot of groups that do, like, the cutesy, beautiful kind of girly concepts, a lot of their choreo is, you know, upper body stuff. A lot of stuff with the hands. The difference between a lot of these groups that do that and GFriend is the handwork. My God. Like, they're so intricate with their handwork. Right there. That is such a nice canon. And, like, it's not a simple canon. They could have easily just done, like, a sweeping motion. But, like, you know, the pause with the bends in the wrist. So nice. Really, really good at these transitions too. And it's crazy because, like, with a song like this, you expect flowing kind of transitions, but they are so powerful. Like, they're powerful, pause, and they milk. God, so much texture too. No crazy change in the levels besides, like, their opening move, but these little micro changes in the levels are so nice. And their spin. Oh my God, that was nice. But yeah, like, their spins too. You don't notice, but whenever they spin, they're just doing like a heel spin, but it's so quick, and then it just pauses and flows right into the next move. These girls can dance, man. These girls can dance. That's my girl right there. She wasn't blonde when I saw her last time. She was like brunette. There it is again. God, man, that's nice. I love that part right there too. Like, the way it hits the music and it just kind of like sweeps out like that. God, I love that move. There's so much I want to like talk about, and I can't keep up because they're doing so many great things in this practice right now. Like, I'm gonna go back and I'll try to like cover what I remember. But yeah, look at that spin right there. Little change in the levels and these transitions, man. They just kind of sweep right into these transitions, and like these spins, God, I love these spins. God, they're so graceful and yet so powerful. Like, it's such a rare combination for like the concepts they roll with. That was crazy. Like, I don't think they've won Best Choreography for a while. I think it's been like 2 or 3 years since they last won. I think Twice has won the past 2 years in a row, and oh my God. Like, don't get me wrong, I love Twice. If y'all, you know, have checked out my other reactions, you guys know I love Twice, but GFriend's choreography, I think, should have won them Best Choreo the years that Twice won it. Oh my God, these girls. And what's crazy is, like, this choreo has been beautiful. I don't think that they're going to win it this year either. Not because of Twice, but because Luna came out, and their choreo was the best I've ever seen. Oh, nice. End it how you finish it, ladies. That's beautiful. That is so beautiful. Wait, I got goosebumps. I got freaking goosebumps from that. So I just want to get to that one part where they do a canon, because they do it so well, and it looks so simple, but it's very intricate. Oh my God, so clean. So let me break that down real quick here. Canoning, or canon, is like doing the wave. Alright, so, you know, when you're at a stadium or a concert, you know, one person kind of rises up, and the person next to them does it, and before you know it, that movement is sweeping across the seats. So, in dance, we call that canon. So, what they had right there is, you know, they had that one girl in purple in the front. They had everyone shadowing behind her, and she led the first motion. And then all the other girls followed behind. However, I feel like most groups and most girls that follow this concept, with a setup like that, they would have just done, like, a generic sweeping motion or something like that. These girls, you know, went out, up, you know, bent the wrist, you know, it was just so detailed. And that's what I was saying earlier. These girls are so detailed with their handwork, you know, and they make things that you would normally see just like that much better. And the tableaus are on point. I'll get to that as well. This part right here, right there, that is beautiful. So something so simple as like, you know, my girl someone taking point right there and just kind of reaching out, and all the other ones just kind of wrap out around her to create like those wings. Like, that is a tableau, that is a picture. So when you look at pictures, you could say, like, as a cameraman, if I were to snap a photo of that, you could say that is a, you know, that is an angel. That is an angel spreading her wings. A picture was created, a tableau was created. And these girls do it on a number of occasions throughout, like, all of their MVs, throughout all of their choreo, I see them do it. And this one, I saw them do it, like, at least 4 or 5 times. And it was all different. And, you know, it was just so, so cool to see. So, guys, that was GFriend's Sunrise Dance Practice. And I gotta say, beautiful, just absolutely beautiful. These girls can for sure dance, and I really should look more into them. I really should, because they're so talented. I mean, having met someone, I think that she is such a lovely person, and I'm sure the rest of them are as well, so maybe I'll give their V-Live a look. But yeah, speaking of the choreo, I mean, great stuff. I'm not surprised. They've been killing it ever since they debuted, and if it were any other year, I would say that this is a strong candidate for Choreo of the Year. It was so beautiful, so, so beautiful, but unfortunately, Luna's Butterfly is the best girl group choreo I have ever seen, like, ever. So I'm pretty sure that's probably going to win best choreo for a girl group this year. But yeah, I mean, these girls should have won it last year and the year before that, because they are so good. And yeah, I mean, I hope that more people recognize how talented they are as dancers. I mean, their voices are so beautiful, but like as dancers, like this is some amazing stuff right here. Just the level of detail that they have in their choreography is just, it's really great to see. And yeah, I kind of really hope that someday their company lets them do, like, you know, a hard-hitting concept, like Girl Crush or something like that, because I believe that they can, you know, really get it. I believe that they could do some, like, hard-hitting, high-tempo choreo, and I think it would look great. But yeah, they seem to be doing well with this concept. It sells, and it really does fit them, fits how they move with it. But yeah, anyway, thank you so much for checking out my channel, you guys. If you like what you see, hit that like button. If you like some more, subscribe. If you have any, you know, recommendations or, you know, any thoughts or opinions, leave a comment down below and I'll check it out. Anyways, thanks again for checking me out, and I'll see you guys next week. Take it easy.